Today, I'll show you how I build a hand crank shredder for recycling plastics. Let's take a look at the building process and what I want to use the processed material for. Guten Tag everybody, I'm Stefan and welcome to CNC Kitchen. This video is sponsored by Squarespace. Create your own beautifully looking website by browsing squarespace.com/cnckitchen. More on Squarespace at the end of this video. Almost 1.5 years ago, I released my most popular video to date, in which I recycled failed 3D prints into new filament using the filler extruder. One of the steps in this process is chopping down the material that I want to use. I tried a blender and a modified paper shredder in the past, which worked for small parts and supports, but things, even only like a 3D banshee, were just a no-go. The paper shredder was overwhelmed with everything bigger than support structure, and the blender either wasn't able to chop down the material or pulverized it. Having a consistent particle size for the subsequent processes is very important, and I wasn't able to achieve that so far. I also recently received a direct pellet extruder made by Mahor, which is very picky with the particles you feed it. Since there is quite a lot of interest in that field in general, and in order to do it properly and have the possibility to also shred things like PET bottles, I bought myself a beefy plastic shredder. Since I'm lacking space, I tried to make it hand-powered, which was a bit of a challenge. If you don't want to miss that, stay until the end. And for more recycling projects, make sure that you're subscribed to the channel and have selected the notification bell. I thought about buying a used professional shredder, but since my workshop is not the biggest, I had to find an alternative. Until the last video released, I wasn't aware of Precious Plastics. That is an initiative with a goal to reduce plastic waste. They provide a bunch of open source tools that everyone can use to start recycling plastics. One of those machines is their shredder. It is mostly made out of sheet metal that can quite easily be sourced in any laser shop around the world. The even better thing is the Precious Plastics Bazar, which is a marketplace where you can buy parts and materials so that you don't need to source everything on your own. I browsed around, compared prices, and decided to purchase a fully stainless steel shredder unit for 320 euros plus 50 bucks of shipping. That arrived within around 2 weeks. I basically received a box with a bunch of laser cut parts, plus the turned axle, the bearings, and a couple of bolts. Most of the parts were deburred, but it's usually a good idea to check them before assembly and use a file if cleanup is necessary. Assembly was pretty much straightforward, and Precious Plastics provides a nice instructional video that goes over all steps. The only slight modification that I did was to drill holes in the end of the axle and thread them to later attach a stop for my hand crank. I also learned during this process that it's a good idea to use the right tool for the job. Stacking the shredder blades was kind of satisfying. I followed the manual, but depending on the material you run, other stack configurations could also make sense. The good thing about this kit was that it was fully welded together, so I only had to do the bolting job without the need of additional tools. A screen with specifically sized holes is placed below the blades. The part is responsible for only letting particles go through that are properly sized for the later application, so that the shreddings will not jam the extruder. Unfortunately, I just recently noticed that my screen has 8mm holes instead of the 5mm ones that would be suited for the filler extruder or the pellet extruder, so I will need to source another perforated metal plate. The first run was a bit rough because some of the parts rubbed together. I used the file to remove some material at the locations where I felt that the parts binded up. The unit still doesn't run 100% smoothly, but that will change after the first couple of times using it. And there we have it. That's the basic shredder unit. To properly use it in a more industrial application, you would now attach it to a frame and add a really beefy geared motor to it. And with beefy, I mean around 2 kilowatts strong, because it needs a huge amount of torque to chew through materials. Since my shop is too small for the complete set, and I usually only process small quantities of materials, I really wanted to make it work with a hand crank. So I got an adapter cut from steel that I then filed to the proper dimensions, to which I attached an 80cm long, 25mm thick, hollow square steel pipe. And this is really the bare minimum that I need, because I tried using a 16mm pipe that was just way too weak. I printed a handle in which I pressed two skateboard bearings and attached it with an 8mm bolt to the end of the handle. The assembly is attached to the shredder that itself is attached to the table via vice clamps. Not a perfect solution yet, and I need to rise it a little for a material drawer below, but a starting point. It really works, sometimes requires a tremendous amount of force, but it's now even able to chew through thick bits of material. I might get myself a decently sized flywheel cut out to add some inertia, but if I'm not going through a couple of kilos of material at a time, a workable solution at this point. The only thing that I still need to fix is that it's horribly dangerous, and also the shredded material flies everywhere. Lacking a welder, I had to make myself a kind of funnel out of wood. I cut OSB to the proper dimensions and added a small hole for a window with my multi-tool. Then I screwed everything together. And here we finally have my, for the moment, finished hand crank shredder. And shredding it does. I mostly went through PLA, but I also tried PET bottles and HDPE bottle caps, which it cut down to small pieces without any major issues. Really cool. The big hand crank is definitely necessary, because even with only little material in it, I sometimes have to pull with my whole weight, which results in a torque of around 500 Newton meters. If you have ideas what I could be shredding in the future and then print with it, leave a comment down below. The shredded material is basically ready now, but both my filler extruder and the direct pellet extruder work the best if the particle size is fairly similar. In order to ensure that, I designed and printed simple stackable sieves, where the sieving part is just the exposed infill and the mesh size is adjusted by changing the infill ratio. Link to those in the description, by the way. I now stack them up with the finest one on the bottom and pour my shreddings in the uppermost one. Then I shake everything around and finally end up with the different particle size fractions. The most upper one is bigger than 5mm and goes back into the shredder. The smallest one, that also includes woods and metal shavings, unfortunately goes into the trash at the moment. The remaining material is now ready for the filler extruder as well as the pellet extruder and should result in way more consistent extrusions as before. Let me know down below what you think of this project. what you would have done differently, and what I can do with it in future videos. Since quite a while, I've been posting write-ups with additional images, graphs, and code on my website that I created using today's sponsor, Squarespace. Squarespace is the all-in-one platform to build a beautifully looking online presence. Setting up a website is really simple, even without any previous knowledge in that field, because they have a ton of professional templates for you to start with and free stock photos for quick customization. Their online editor is really intuitive to use and helps you create and maintain your website with no hassle at all. If you also have a business or just want to share your latest hacks and prints, try it out totally free at squarespace.com/cnckitchen. When you're ready to launch, use code cnckitchen to get 10% off your first purchase. Just give it a try, and if you're ever stuck, you can probably find a solution to your problem in their great help center. Thank you, Squarespace, for supporting this channel. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this investigation interesting and learned something new. If you did, then please leave a like and make sure that you're subscribed. If you want to support my work, then take a look at the description and become a patron or a YouTube member. Also, check out the rest of my videos. I'm sure you'll enjoy them. I'll see you in the next one. Auf Wiedersehen and goodbye.